This episode of DNews is brought to you by Domain.com. Okay, so I know we're a little behind in meme time, but we know that goats crave that mineral, but why do we crave anything at all? Cravings are a strange phenomena, and it's not just pregnant women who get them. Folk wisdom says that craving a mineral means you might have a mineral deficiency, but let's be real here. If that worked, then we would crave healthy foods rather than mac and cheese and chocolate. Recently, researchers from the Pekauer Institute for Learning and Memory looked at sugar cravings in mice to see what was going on in the brain. They looked at the relationship between the ventral tegmental area, which is the brain's natural reward processing center, and the lateral hypothalamus, which is responsible for feeding. They used a technique called optogenetics. This process uses light to trigger light-sensitive proteins that can activate or silence a set of neurons that connect these two parts of the brain. When activated, the mice stuffed their faces with sweetness and overate even when they weren't hungry. When silenced, the mice still ate regular food when they were hungry, but they no longer compulsively ate the sugar. This indicated that the neural circuit for sugar cravings is a different circuit than the one that regulates healthy eating. Mice aside, for us, most cravings start with a cue. Think of Pavlov's dogs. Something happens that just gets your mouth watering, like dreaming of your mom's roast beef as soon as you land back in your hometown, or craving ice cream on a hot summer day. Another cue for most people is stress, which can trigger cravings for comfort food. We crave chocolate during hormonal fluctuations, not for any biological reason. We've just come to associate the chocolate with comfort during a pretty uncomfortable time of the month. Cravings feel so strong because they're so vivid in the mind. The very act of craving a food, not just being hungry or wanting to eat, but craving something like ice cream or chocolate, conjures up images in the brain, which uses up cognitive resources. One study showed that those who craved chocolate did worse on memory and math problems. We can literally distract ourselves with our cravings. And we typically crave high caloric foods stuffed with fat and sugar because they were a rarity in our evolutionary past. We evolved a reward system associated with these foods. When we eat sweets, our brain kicks off a cascade of chemistry. Feel-good hormones like dopamine and serotonin flood our system, giving us a bit of a sugar high. So when we're stressed and need a bit of a pick-me-up, we turn to these foods. While we all crave something at some point in our lives, unusual cravings might be a sign of an underlying medical condition. Craving salt? You might have Addison's disease. Addison's disease affects the endocrine system, leading to electrolyte imbalances. The adrenal glands don't make enough cortisol or aldosterone. Aldosterone helps the body hold on to the salt it needs. When you don't make enough of it, you wind up with an unusually strong desire to eat salty things. Craving chalk or paint chips, you might have pica, named from the Latin for magpie because of the belief magpies will eat literally anything. Pica is the bizarre behavior of eating things like clay, chalk, soap, dirt, or even rocks. Scientists think a lack of nutrients might be the cause of this craving. Maybe an iron deficiency, celiac disease, or hookworm. A mental health related illness like OCD or schizophrenia might also lead someone to chow down on chalk. By the way, if you're craving a better website, why not buy a domain name from domain.com? No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. Want to learn more about cravings? Click here and let Lacey tell you more about how they can be caused by high stress. And be sure to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.